Good evening. I'm Jim Gordon at Shea Stadium in New York for tonight's lightweight championship fight between Carlos Ortiz and Ismael Laguna. It is a hot and muggy night in New York. To bring you all the blow-by-blow, the action, and the pre-fight dope, your blow-by-blow commentator, Don Duffy. Don?
Thank you, Jim Gordon. You fans are in for what I think is going to be an ideal boxing match. A bout between a boxer puncher with KO power in either fist. That would be the lightweight champion, a great lightweight champion, Carlos Ortiz. And his opponent is going to make moves in the ring that is going to remind many of you of the great scientific boxers of the past. Shades of Willie Pep and Sugar Ray Robinson. That would be the challenger, Ismael Laguna. Now here's Johnny Addy.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Here are the ring officials assigned by the New York State Athletic Commission. The judges, Jack Gordon, Al Burr. The timekeeper, Fred Abatello. Counting for the knockdowns, Al Lynn. Referee for the main event, Arthur Mercanti. 15 rounds. For the lightweight championship of the world, introducing from Panama, he's wearing red trunks, he weighs 135, the former lightweight king, Ismael Laguna.
A big ovation for the challenger and former champion.
His opponent, from Puerto Rico, wearing blue trunks, same weight, 135, the lightweight champion of the world, Carlos Ortiz.
And a tremendous ovation for the lightweight champion, Carlos Ortiz.
My instructions. This is perhaps the most important event in your lives. We expect to maintain strict discipline in the ring this evening. This bout will be governed by the rules of the New York State Athletic Commission. In the event of a knockdown, you must take an eight count. Three knockdowns in one round will automatically end the contest. You must break when you're given the command. Break clean. Shake hands now. Come out boxing at the bell.
Round one of a 15-round bout for the lightweight championship of the world. On the right-hand side, Ismael Laguna from Panama, the challenger. On the left, Carlos Ortiz, the champion. The bell for round one, 3-minute rounds. I'd like you to watch Laguna's great footwork. Ortiz surprised him with that flurry that time. Laguna will slip punches, block them. He'll crouch and duck a lot. He'll keep on the move. He'll try to irritate Carlos Ortiz and get him off balance. However, I want you to notice this. Carlos Ortiz has great balance. He's always ready to punch. The third and rubber meeting between the two. Each has won one of them. Has a fine left hook followed by a crossing right. He'll try to set his man up with that left hook and bring the right over it. If he gets in close, Laguna is one of the few fighters who can use an inside uppercut. About 2,000 fans from Panama have come up to root for Laguna, their favorite. Round one is half over. Our Ortiz is wearing the lighter trunks of the two. Laguna is wearing the dark trunks, if you're watching in black and white. Those punches were blocked by Laguna. Laguna is 6 years younger than Ortiz, has youth on his side. Ortiz has the experience. About 30 seconds left in round one. Ortiz fighting a deliberate fight, hoping his opponent will make a mistake. He's going to work the body, trying to slow down the faster Laguna. 10 seconds left in round one.
The first round, it was evident, as Don told you, that Ortiz is a counterpuncher. Mostly because he kept waiting for Laguna to lead, and Laguna's corners crossed him up a little bit. Laguna kept waiting for Ortiz to bring the action to him. About the hardest punches in the entire fight were the first three thrown by the champion, Carlos Ortiz. And they did, as Don told you, surprise Laguna just a little bit. After that, it was simply a case of stalking each other, each corner apparently waiting for the other guy to make the lead. Now, there doesn't seem to be any chance that the strategy is going to change from Ortiz's standpoint. The second for yelling to him during that first round as it went on by to do exactly as he was told. Wait, 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 baby. And about the only punches he was able to throw later on in the fight that got to Laguna, all were, as Don told you, blocked quite effectively. So it's round one. This one is underway. From here on in, it'll be tight.
Round two at Shea Stadium for the lightweight title. Hard to the body by the champion, Carlos Ortiz. He's wearing the lighter trunks. Laguna, the darker trunks. Now Laguna is picking up the pace. The fast Panamanian is speeding it up. Those were good punches by Laguna. You'll notice that Laguna keeps his gloves up higher, Ortiz down lower. Both men came in at exactly the lightweight limit, 135. They know, of course, that Laguna does not understand English. Ortiz scoring with those jolting chops to the face. Both have been working the body very well. Arthur McCanty, the referee, staying well out of the action. In round two. The thousands of rooters of each boy are chanting in the background. You probably can hear them. Ortiz trying to lure his man into a lead so he can counter. Laguna doesn't fall for it. Thank you. 10 seconds left in round two.
Is the showroom shine on your old car just a sun-faded memory? Got a newer car that you're constantly polishing and waxing just to keep looking new? Not anymore.
Hi, Joe Fowler in a junkyard, and this is Restores It from Simonize,
the amazing once-a-year car treatment that restores, polishes, and protects the finish on any car, any color, in any condition for one full year.
Even a junkyard dog like this.
Just spray and wipe it away. Like magic, Restores It cuts through years of wear and tear, restoring the shine you thought was gone forever. Restores It is a once-a-year, 3-in-1 car finish treatment. It's a paint revitalizer that brings old paint back to life right before your very eyes. It's a professional detailer's polish that puts Simonize shine on any car, any color, in any condition. And it's a premium wax that seals and protects the Simonize shine for one full year. After 12 months and 100 washes, the water still beads up and runs away. If your car's finish is prime before its time, Restores It will turn back the hands of time. Ugly oxidation? Repair the devastation, swirl marks, and scratches with Restores It. Want to keep that classic looking classic? Restores It. And if you're tired of constantly waxing, get Restores It. Just spray and wipe it away once a year. And now Restores It with a professional microfiber finishing cloth is yours for just $9.95. It's from Simonize, the most trusted automotive brand in America for the last 100 years. Order now. We'll double the offer and send a second Restores It and microfiber cloth free. Just pay separate processing and handling. That's two for the price of one. And Restores It comes with an unconditional one-year money-back guarantee. If your car loses its showroom shine anytime in the next year, return the empty bottles and we'll refund your money. Restore, polish, and protect for a full year and a one-year money-back guarantee. Get Restores It from Simonize for only $9.95. Here's how to order.
This TV offer is not yet available in stores, so call now at 1-800-871-6984. That's 1-800-871-6984, or go to buyrestoresit.com.
Sunday Night Baseball. Every week, the best in the game are on baseball's biggest stage. Sunday night at 8 on ESPN, ESPN3.com, and ESPN Radio.
Round 5 at Shea Stadium. The champion, Carlos Ortiz, looking confident in the blue trunks. If you're watching in color, Ismael Laguna, the challenger, in the red. In black and white, Ortiz has the lighter trunks, Laguna the dark ones. Laguna, a fine champion himself, next champion now, is not flinching from Ortiz despite being rocked in the last round. Ortiz definitely trying for an early knockout. Laguna has been going for the body a lot more than we expected him to. Every so often, Ortiz looks over at his corner. The last time he looked, he was tagged by Laguna. They yell at Ortiz, wait till he comes in. Don't lead, they yell at him. Ortiz has a slight cut above the right eye. Ortiz, a slight cut by the right eye, just above the right side of it. 1 minute to go in round 5. There have been no knockdowns yet. Laguna was rocked in round 4 and in this one. Now Ortiz has got to worry about that eye. He's got good corner man, Chicky Ferrara, Teddy Bentham, and manager Bill Daly. Nevertheless, it could be troublesome. Laguna holding Ortiz against the ropes. 25 seconds left in the round. 10 seconds left in round five.
That cut on Ortiz in his right eye, meaty part just below the eyebrow and just above the eyelash. Corner man, as Don told you, are working on it now, and he's got good corner men. It became a little bit obvious during the round in watching Laguna that something that Don had pointed out to you earlier might be the most important part of the fight. Laguna was content to bide his time, and perhaps he too is counting on this very, very hot night and the fact that Ortiz is 30 years old. It might very well work to his advantage as the fight goes on longer and longer. Ortiz seemed to be trying to take his man out that time. He had his feet planted several times. He was looking for that one good hard shot. Ortiz is still moving well. We don't mean to indicate here he's showing any signs of tiredness at all. As a matter of fact, both men are moving just as freshly as they did when round one began. But it could be something to watch as this hot night and fight combine at Shea Stadium in New York.
Round six at Shea Stadium. Champion Carlos Ortiz on the right, Laguna on the left. Laguna sneaking in some pretty good punches himself, as you see. Champion Ortiz looks supremely confident. Laguna looks about the same as when he started. Ortiz again trying to set him up for that devastating right hand. Laguna very often will lead with his own right as he did then, and sometimes he gets away with it, but that was a half-hearted maneuver. 2 minutes left in the round, a hard left hook that time by the champion. Every so often, Ortiz looks out. He seems to be counting the house. There's a good crowd here, Carlos. More to worry about by Ortiz is that right eye. It's starting to bleed again just above it. And Laguna knows it. And so does Ortiz. This is round six. Bobbing head of Laguna's is hard to hit with a jab. One minute left in the round. A good 1-2 by the champion. Streak of blood down the face of Ortiz. Laguna speeding it up again. Ortiz with those good left hooks, and so is Laguna. Ten seconds left in round six.
I don't want to get up. I don't want to go to work. I hate mornings. Great, I have 20 minutes. No time for coffee. Hello, my friend.
Can't get it together in the morning? Try 5-Hour Energy. It's simple, effective, and unlike coffee, it's ready right now. No waiting, no hassle.
Let's do this.
5-Hour Energy, the no wait, no hassle way to a great morning.
This is getting good, real good. Who will move on in the NBA's ultimate drama? I can tell you from firsthand experience, this is special. Bulls. Hawks, Game 6, Thursday at 8 on ESPN.
The new Watch ESPN app. The ESPN network's live on your phone and tablet. This is a public announcement. CNNMoney.com reports that in some areas of the country, buyers are scooping up homes for as little as $1,000. Foreclosures are at an all-time high. Government and private banks are liquidating these homes now. If you currently rent a house or apartment, you may call now and learn how to receive your free list of these homes. All others may call tomorrow. Every house must be sold. This is a public announcement.
Call 1-800-796-7086. That's 1-800-796-7086. Call now.
This is where I run my home business. And so can you.
Hit it!
You can get started right away. Log on now and we'll send you your free internet starter pack that will guide you through the step-by-step process to setting up your own home-based business.
My first month, I made over $2,700 profit.
If I can do it, you can do it. Get your internet starter pack today.
You can be making money wherever you are, right now. What are you waiting for?
Log on now and get your free internet starter pack today.
Round 7 of this fast lightweight championship bout produced by Madison Square Garden Boxing at Shea Stadium. Carlos Ortiz, the lightweight champion, wearing the blue trunks, Laguna, the red trunks. Ortiz got mad that time and scored heavily with that left hook a couple of times. Ortiz, crafty champion, trying to lure his opponent into an opening for him. No question, Ortiz has scored the heavier punches tonight. See that 1-2 by Ortiz, the left and then the right, and the corner is right back at him. Laguna keeps working the body of the older man. Older, he's 30 years old. Older by 6 years. One minute left in round 7. Hardly been a dull moment. Laguna seems to be getting his second win. Ortiz scoring heavily and making Laguna hold. This is a great round of boxing. Ortiz looks at his corner again. Ten seconds left in round 7.
This lightweight championship fight is the first one outdoors in some 19 years in New York. And once the dam broke, they're going to do it again. There's going to be a middleweight championship fight coming up on the 28th, right here at Shea Stadium again. That'll be the first one since Basilio beat Sugar Ray Robinson back in 57. Nino Benvenuti and Emil Grizzle. And that one, too, should be a beauty. This is September 28th. Here, Carlos Ortiz corner again, and they're working on the eye, but again, just don't seem overly concerned right now. Just about ready, as Ismael Laguna shows signs of stepping up the pace for the first time in the fight.
Round 8 at Shea Stadium. Carlos Ortiz, the lightweight champion in the blue or the lighter trunks. Ismael Laguna in the red or the darker trunks. There have been no knockdowns. Laguna was rocked in round 4 and 5. Did not go down. Laguna is now keeping the pressure on the champion, although Carlos is more than holding his own. Laguna's best punch of the fight. Heavily that time. Arthur McCanny trying to get them apart. Ortiz was cut around the right eye as early as the fourth round, but it hasn't bothered him. But I do see another trickle of blood over there. Laguna apparently unmarked. A minute to go in round 8. Now Laguna seems to be showing more respect for Ortiz. Seconds left in round 8.
Ripped washboard abs. You know you want them. But crunches provide only limited short muscle contractions and create stress on your neck, shoulders, and lower back. Time to drop the excuses and get the T-Core for Men, the ab workout that revolutionizes the crunch, taking it off the floor and turbocharging it with a long-range motion against progressive resistance that targets your abs with every rep. In fact, T-Core delivers a gut-busting workout in 3 power moves that will target your entire core, upper abs, lower abs, and obliques. 1. Plug in the T-Core and feel your upper abs absolutely ignite as they compress the resistance cylinder. Resistance that generates a long, intense muscle contraction, a contraction that creates rock-hard chisel-cut abs fast. 2. Move T-Core to the side to instantly fire your oblique muscles and sculpt your waist. 3. Lean back for a leg raise that will completely zero in on your lower abs. 3 exercises, 6 minutes that will push you to the limit. T-Core will keep challenging you with 3 settings of 40, 80, even 120 pounds of ab crunching resistance. It's like doing a lat pull against a 100-pound weight stack without the expensive equipment. T-Core can be yours for 1 payment. That's right, just 1 payment of only $29.95. T-Core comes with a 6-minute DVD workout and this gut check guarantee. Do the workout once. If you don't feel the burn in your upper abs, lower abs, and obliques without the strain on your neck and back, return it for a full refund of the purchase price. If you're serious about getting chiseled speed bump abs, T-Core for Men is the elite abdominal exercise you've been looking for. 3 exercises, 6 minutes, and only $29.95? Now there's no excuse. It's gut check time. Call now or go online to www.tc4men.com and order now.
Round 10 here at Shea Stadium, presented by Madison Square Garden Boxing. Lightweight championship of the world, the champion, Carlos Ortiz. Sparring with that solid right hand. Still looking at his corner for instructions. Arthur McCanny gets them apart. Ortiz, the blue or the lighter trunks. Laguna, the red or the dark trunks. No knockdowns in the fight. Bit more holding in this round than usual. Showing their good left jabs in this round. Now Laguna puts on a show. Ortiz scoring heavily with both hands, one at a time. Round 10 half over. Round 10 of a 15-round bout for the lightweight championship. Ortiz in charge at the moment. They say protect yourself at all times. Ortiz scoring heavily. Seconds left in the round. A big round for the champion. Hard, 10 seconds left in round 10.
As Ortiz spun around, there was Laguna's face sitting right out in front. He scored a couple of pretty good sharp punches. It was a good round for Ortiz. Laguna, we're looking at him now, 135 pounds for this fight, a little bit heavier than most had expected him, although there's not too much to pick and choose from when you get down to weights this fine. He's 5'9", and yet doesn't have too much more reach than Ortiz. He comes from Colón, Panama. He was born there. Family of some 14 children. And this has had a tendency in the past to make quite a few fighters. You know, when you have to scramble yourself amongst a whole pile of sisters and brothers, you learn the reflexes pretty good. Ismael Laguna.
Round 11 at Shea Stadium. Carlos Ortiz, the champion, fighting a smart fight. Ismael Laguna, the former champion and challenger. No knockdowns in the fight so far. Ortiz is hitting sparingly, but he's making the most of his punches. No question about that. He forced Laguna to break off the action there for a moment. 2 minutes left in round 11. No one knows, of course, how the rest of the bout will go, but up until now, Ortiz has shown why he is such a great champion, why he has been such a great champion. He seems to have everything in there, including good corner men. Is told to lead with a right hand, as they hope Laguna will run into it. Half a minute left in this round.
And turn all night. Your back aches and your neck is in a knot. Introducing the all-new Sobakawa Cloud Pillow. A pillow 300 years in the making, based on the traditional Asian buckwheat pillow. The Sobakawa Cloud is filled with over 10 million air beads, a virtual sea of clouds that support your head and neck while keeping you cool and comfortable. Ordinary pillows are shaped like bricks. The Sobakawa Cloud's unique crescent shape is designed to follow the contours of your neck and shoulders. As you move, the beads move with you, maintaining both comfort and support. Plus, you'll never have to keep fluffing and flipping like ordinary pillows. This is truly a stay cool pillow.
I feel refreshed. And I don't feel the back of my hair stuck to my head because of its coolness.
Your head weighs about 10 pounds. If you don't get support, you wake feeling worse than when you went to bed. We placed eggs on the bottom of these cylinders, filled this cylinder with feathers from an expensive pillow. This 10-pound weight crushes the feathers and smashes the eggs. In this tube, we have stuffing from a fiber pillow, and it offers little resistance. Then we tried memory foam, and the weight wins again. Now watch as the weight hits the air beads. They absorb the shock, and the eggs are safe. Ordinary pillows flatten and lose their shape. The Sobakawa Cloud Pillow will keep its shape sleep after sleep after sleep. Order your Sobakawa Cloud Pillow for just $19.99. Order today and will also include the Sobakawa Pillowcase, a $10 value, and it's yours free. It's designed to breathe and continually adjust to the shape of the pillow. But wait, call right now and we'll double your order. You'll receive a second Sobakawa pillow and pillowcase for just the shipping and handling. That's just $19.99 for two Sobakawa pillows plus two free pillowcases. But you have to call now.
To order your Sobakawa Cloud Pillow, call 1-800-409-3128. Call now and get a second pillow for free. Call 1-800-409-3128 and order today.
Thanks to the Watch ESPN app, I don't miss nothing.
The new Watch ESPN app. The ESPN network's live on your phone and tablet.
Round 12 at Shea Stadium, lightweight championship, produced by Madison Square Garden Boxing, Harry Markson director. Question is now, can Laguna make it? He has had quite a going over in the last couple of rounds from Carlos Ortiz. Ortiz has not been able to bring him down, however. Ortiz in the lighter trunks or the blue trunks. Laguna, the dark trunks or the red trunks, depending on whether you're watching in black and white or in color. round 12 of a 15-round bout for the lightweight championship, now owned by Carlos Ortiz. Ortiz is completely dominating the fight now. Laguna just can't get set. The same boxing he can't get off. Laguna is game, punching back. Seconds left in round 12.
This may be the most valuable American silver coin ever issued. You are looking at the magnificent Grand Canyon .999 fine silver bullion coin recently released by the U.S. government to celebrate America's national parks and historic sites. This giant 5-ounce silver bullion coin is the largest and heaviest silver coin ever issued by the United States, with one of the rarest mintings in U.S. history. The issue price of these bullion coins was officially set at under $200. However, the demand for this rarity has caused the price to skyrocket to $1,000 or more per Grand Canyon coin, and that's if you can even find one. But now, Americans can acquire this stunning tribute-proof layered in pure 24-karat gold through a private non-monetary minting by the New England Mint, featuring the Grand Canyon on the reverse and the historic portrait of George Washington on the obverse. This tribute is overlaid with over 23 milligrams of 24-karat gold and features the brilliant mirror-like background and frosted images prized by collectors and investors alike. Each Grand Canyon tribute-proof is slightly larger than the famous U.S. Morgan silver dollar and is mint-struck in deep dimension to highlight its exquisite detail. The issue price for the Grand Canyon Tribute Proof was originally set at $30, but with this exclusive TV offer, it can be yours for the low price of only $10, plus processing and handling. Reserve your copy now, as initial strikes of these magnificent proofs are limited and certain to go fast. Every 24-karat gold layered tribute proof comes in a protective clear case and has an individually numbered certificate of authenticity. Earliest orders receive the lowest serial numbers. All orders are protected with a 6-month money-back guarantee. Due to the recent increases in the price of gold, the special release price of $10 may be withdrawn at any time. Don't wait. Reserve your Grand Canyon Tribute Proof today. Yours for the special collector's price of just $10. Here's how to order.
To order your gold Grand Canyon Tribute Proof for $10 plus processing and handling, call 1-800-390-6921. That's 1-800-390-6921 or go to gcproof.com. Supplies are limited, so call now.
Round 13 at Shea Stadium, the lightweight championship of the world, is the bauble they're battling for. Arthur McCanty, the referee, comes over to get them apart. Ortiz, the champion, the lighter trunks. Laguna, the darker trunks, which are bright red. There have been no knockdowns. Laguna still full of fight. Laguna brisk in their exchanges again. A slight mouse forming below the right eye of Ortiz. Ortiz with a beautiful countering right hand. Flush on the button. His legion of rooters in the background are shouting in unison, Carlos, Carlos. A whipping straight right hand. Ortiz has all the equipment, no question about it. Not nearly as fast as Laguna, but apparently he doesn't have to be. Half a minute left in the round. Ortiz slightly cut about by both eyes, by the corners of them, and swelling below the right eye. Laguna unmarked. 10 seconds left in round 13.
Wearing Shape Ups is my new workout partner. I feel so good, I decided to do something a little unconventional. With my Shape Ups, I'm walking back to the game I love.
Shape Ups, get back in the game.
You got this in my size?
Baseball tonight is on the road, live from the iconic ballparks of America. Our team breaks down the Sunday night matchup from the clubhouse, in the dugout, and on the field. Baseball tonight, live from the ballpark, Sundays at 7 on ESPN.
Is it hot in here? How's that? You guys sure you're all right? Everybody all right?
No, we're good, but how are you holding up?
Oh, it's been 2 years and I'm still sore. I mean, everyone out there took a beating. And if they're going to work every play, I got to work every play. What am I going to do? Cry? Go home? Take myself and go home? In game six? Forget it. I didn't think I was going to make it. But, you know, I wouldn't take it back.
Bulls, Hawks, game six, Thursday at 8 on ESPN. Imagine, with a simple push of a button, you could be on your way to getting firm, sculpted abs and a sexy waistline with the Contour Core Sculpting System. It's the breakthrough technology that requires no machines, no getting on the floor, no stress, and no strain.
Contour, contour.
The contour is the real deal.
The secret is Contour's exclusive auto-active muscle toning technology, the digital breakthrough that automatically targets all your abdominal muscles, including your upper abs, lower abs, obliques, and even that stubborn lower belly. Thermographic testing proves Contour activates your entire core. The Contour Core Sculpting System comes with a one-size-fits-all Contour Core Belt, electronic controller with custom digital settings, batteries, and a one-year warranty, plus an instructional guide and sensible eating plan. And it's all yours to try for 30 days for just $14.95. There's never been an easier, more effective way to get great-looking abs. So call and order right now.
Round 14 at Shea Stadium. Champion Carlos Ortiz doing a masterful job against the game and gallant challenger Ismael Laguna. Ortiz, the trunks with the white stripe down the side, the lighter trunks. Laguna, the darker trunks. Remember September 28th, that's when Nino Benvenuti defends the middleweight title against Emil Griffith here at Shea Stadium, promoted by Madison Square Garden Boxing. Laguna with a brief rally. Laguna apparently has been told by his corner that the only way he can win is by a knockout, and he's probably going to go out and try to get it. scoring in New York on a rounds basis with a supplementary point system if the rounds come out even on the cards of the... Ortiz knocked out Flash Alordi last year at Madison Square Garden. Gomez is game as they come. He's still carrying the fight to him. Ten seconds left in this round.
World lightweight champion Carlos Ortiz scoring at will. It was almost like he was using a heavy bag in the gym with the kind of punches that you're just not supposed to be able to score. He was throwing nothing but solid right-hand leads, wasn't even trying to feint. Laguna wasn't sitting duck for him. And there's no doubt about the fact that Laguna was hurt as badly in that one as he has ever been hurt in this fight. Carlos Ortiz stands head and shoulders right now as the lightweight king. He has done just about everything correct in this fight. He's got just one more round. And again, we'll repeat, it would take something awfully dramatic. Laguna tried to make that thing dramatic happen that time. He came out throwing bombs, obviously told by his corner he had to knock his man out. But when he decided to slug, he was out slugged. And that perhaps could have been the end right there.
There's the 15th and final round, and the question seems to be now, can Laguna go the distance? Carlos Ortiz, the lightweight champion. He's been, Laguna was good tonight, no mistake, but Ortiz was great. There have been no knockdowns, although Laguna has been rocked a few times. Ortiz in the lighter trunks with the white stripe down the side, Laguna with the dark trunks. Ortiz has been devastatingly accurate with that right hand, no question about it. Laguna won the title from Ortiz back in 1965. Ortiz regained it a few months later. Ortiz seems to be defending it well tonight. This is the 15th and final round. Judges are Al Burl and Jack Gordon, and the referee Arthur McCanny. The three of them will give the decision. Should it go the limit? Round 15 is half over. 50 seconds left. 50 seconds. A true professional, Ortiz, trying to get it over with. And Laguna trying to get the knockout himself if he can. But his efforts haven't got the earlier sting. Less than half a minute to go. Laguna just scored with a brilliant uppercut, but it's too late, I'm afraid, for him. Ortiz has fought a great fight. 10 seconds left in the fight. Collecting the cards from Al Burl and Jack Gordon, the judges and the referee, Arthur McCanty, and Dan Dowd and Frank Morris of the commission are going over the cards just to our left. They are studying the cards. We're going to have the decision in just a moment. Three veteran officials, Al Burl, Jack Gordon, and Arthur McCanty, scoring the fight on a rounds basis. Meanwhile, the fighters and the handlers are still in the ring. Who is it, Ortiz? The card of Jack Gordon, I think, will be sent back to him for a correction. No, apparently it's all right. Ortiz being lifted by his handlers. Johnny Addy calling for the microphone. Let's listen.
Referee Arthur McCanty and Judge Al Burr. They both score it. 10 rounds for Ortiz, 4 rounds for Luna, 1 even.
10-4-1, the champion
the
still, Carlos Ortiz.
Scores it 11-3. 1 even, the winner, and still lightweight champion of the world, Carlos Ortiz.
It's been a pleasure for Sports Network Incorporated and Madison Square Garden Sports Presentations to bring you this lightweight championship bout. This is Jim Gordon and Don Dumphy wishing you good night. Good evening. I'm Jim Gordon at Shea Stadium in New York for tonight's lightweight championship fight between Carlos Ortiz and Ismael Laguna. It is a hot and muggy night in New York. To bring you all the blow-by-blow, the action, and the pre-fight dope, your blow-by-blow commentator, Don Dumphy. Don?
Thank you, Jim Gordon. You fans are in for what I think is going to be an ideal boxing match. A bout between a boxer puncher with KO power in either fist. That would be the lightweight champion, a great lightweight champion, Carlos Ortiz. And his opponent is going to make moves in the ring that is going to remind many of you of the great scientific boxers of the past. Shades of Willie Pep and Sugar Ray Robinson. That would be the challenger, Ismael Laguna. Now here's Johnny Addy.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Here are the ring officials assigned by the New York State Athletic Commission. The judges, Jack Gordon, Al Burr. The timekeeper, Fred Abatello. Counting for the knockdowns, Al Lynn. Referee for the main event, Arthur Mercanti. 15 rounds for the lightweight championship of the world. Introducing from Panama, he's wearing red trunks. He weighs 135. The former lightweight king, Ismael Laguna.
A big ovation for the challenger and former champion.
His opponent from Puerto Rico, wearing blue trunks.
A tremendous ovation for the lightweight champion, Carlos Ortiz.
Most important event in your lives. We expect to maintain strict discipline in the ring this evening. This bout will be governed by the rules of the New York State Athletic Commission. In the event of a knockdown, you must take an eight count. Three knockdowns in one round will automatically end the contest. You must break when you're given the command. Break clean. Shake hands now. Come out boxing at the bell.
Round one of a 15-round bout for the lightweight championship of the world. On the right-hand side, Ismael Laguna from Panama, the challenger. On the left, Carlos Ortiz, the champion. The bell for round one, three-minute rounds. I'd like you to watch Laguna's great footwork. Ortiz surprised him with that flurry that time. Laguna will slip punches, block them. He'll crouch and duck a lot. He'll keep on the move. He'll try to irritate Carlos Ortiz and get him off balance. However, I want you to notice this. Carlos Ortiz has great balance. He's always ready to punch. The third and rubber meeting between the two. Each has won one of them. Has a fine left hook followed by a crossing right. He'll try to set his man up with that left hook and bring the right over it. If he gets in close, Laguna is one of the few fighters who can use an inside uppercut. About 2,000 fans from Panama have come up to root for Laguna, their favorite. Round one is half over. Ortiz is wearing the lighter trunks of the two. Laguna is wearing the dark trunks, if you're watching in black and white. Those punches were blocked by Laguna. Laguna is 6 years younger than Ortiz, has youth on his side. Ortiz has the experience. About 30 seconds left in round one. Ortiz fighting a deliberate fight, hoping his opponent will make a mistake. He's going to work the body, trying to slow down the faster Laguna. 10 seconds left in round one.
first round, it was evident, as Don told you, that Ortiz is a counterpuncher. Mostly because he kept waiting for Laguna to lead, and Laguna's corners crossed him up a little bit. Laguna kept waiting for Ortiz to bring the action to him. About the hardest punches in the entire fight with the first three thrown by the champion, Carlos Ortiz. And they did, as Don told you, surprise Laguna just a little bit. After that, it was simply a case of stalking each other, each corner apparently waiting for the other guy to make the lead. Now, there doesn't seem to be any chance that the strategy is going to change from Ortiz's standpoint. The seconds were yelling to him during that first round as it went on by to do exactly as he was told. Wait, 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 baby. And about the only punches he was able to throw later on in the fight that got to Laguna, all were, as Don told you, blocked quite effectively. So it's round one. This one is underway. From here on in, it'll be tight.
Round two at Shea Stadium for the lightweight title. Hard to the body by the champion, Carlos Ortiz. He's wearing the lighter trunks. Laguna, the darker trunks. Now Laguna is picking up the pace. The fast Panamanian is speeding it up. Those were good punches by Laguna. You'll notice that Laguna keeps his gloves up higher, Ortiz down lower. Both men came in at exactly the lightweight limit, 135. They know, of course, that Laguna does not understand English. Ortiz scoring with those jolting chops to the face. Both have been working the body very well. Arthur McCanty, the referee, staying well out of the action. In round two. The thousands of rooters of each boy are chanting in the background. You probably can hear them. Ortiz trying to lure his man into a lead so he can counter. Laguna doesn't fall for it.
Is the showroom shine on your old car just a sun-faded memory? Got a newer car that you're constantly polishing and waxing just to keep looking new? Not anymore.
One minute left in round 12. Laguna is game, but much of the ring savvy apparently has been punched out of him by Ortiz. And a lot of the spring has gone out of those beautiful legs. Laguna is game, punching back. Seconds left in round 12.
This may be the most valuable American silver coin ever issued. You are looking at the magnificent Grand Canyon .999 fine silver bullion coin recently released by the U.S. government to celebrate America's national parks and historic sites. This giant 5-ounce silver bullion coin is the largest and heaviest silver coin ever issued by the United States, with one of the rarest mintings in U.S. history. The issue price of these bullion coins was officially set at under $200. However, the demand for this rarity has caused the price to skyrocket to $1,000 or more per Grand Canyon coin, and that's if you can even find one. But now, Americans can acquire this stunning tribute-proof, layered in pure 24-karat gold through a private, non-monetary minting by the New England Mint, featuring the Grand Canyon on the reverse and the historic portrait of George Washington on the obverse. This tribute is overlaid with over 23 milligrams of 24-karat gold and features the brilliant mirror-like background and frosted images prized by collectors and investors alike. Each Grand Canyon tribute-proof is slightly larger than the famous U.S. Morgan silver dollar and is mint-struck in deep dimension to highlight its exquisite detail. The issue price for the Grand Canyon Tribute Proof was originally set at $30, but with this exclusive TV offer, it can be yours for the low price of only $10 plus processing and handling. Reserve your copy now, as initial strikes of these magnificent proofs are limited and certain to go fast. Every 24-karat gold layered tribute proof comes in a protective clear case and has an individually numbered certificate of authenticity. Earliest orders receive the lowest serial numbers. All orders are protected with a 6-month money back guarantee. Due to the recent increases in the price of gold, the special release price of $10 may be withdrawn at any time. Don't wait. Reserve your Grand Canyon Tribute Proof today. Yours for the special collector's price of just $10. Here's how to order.
To order your gold Grand Canyon Tribute Proof for $10 plus processing and handling, call 1-800-390-6921. That's 1-800-390-6921 or go to gcproof.com. Supplies are limited, so call now.
Round 13 at Shea Stadium, the lightweight championship of the world, is the bauble they're battling for. Arthur McCanty, the referee, comes over to get them apart. Ortiz, the champion, the lighter trunks. Laguna, the darker trunks, which are bright red. There have been no knockdowns. Laguna still full of fight. In their exchanges again. A slight mouse forming below the right eye of Ortiz. Ortiz with a beautiful countering right hand. Flush on the button. His legion of looters in the background are shouting in unison, Carlos, Carlos. A whipping straight right hand. Ortiz has all the equipment, no question about it. Not nearly as fast as Laguna, but apparently he doesn't have to be. Half a minute left in the round. Ortiz slightly cut about by both eyes, by the corners of them, and swelling below the right eye. Laguna unmarked. 10 seconds left in round 13.
Wearing shape-ups is my new workout partner. I feel so good, I decided to do something a little unconventional. With my shape-ups, I'm walking back to the game I love.
Shape-ups, get back in the game.
You got this in my size?
Baseball tonight is on the road, live from the iconic ballparks of America. Our team breaks down the Sunday night matchup from the clubhouse, in the dugout, and on the field. Baseball tonight, live from the ballpark, Sundays at 7 on ESPN.
Is it hot in here? How's that? You guys sure you're all right? Everybody all right?
No, we're good, but how are you holding up?
Oh, it's been 2 years and I'm still sore. I mean, everyone out there took a beating. And if they're going to work every play, I got to work every play. What am I going to do? Cry, go home, take myself and go home. And game six, forget it. I didn't think I was going to make it. But, you know, I wouldn't take it back.
Bulls, Hawks, game six, Thursday at 8 on ESPN. Imagine, with a simple push of a button, you could be on your way to getting firm, sculpted abs and a sexy waistline with the Contour Core Sculpting System. It's the breakthrough technology that requires no machines, no getting on the floor, no stress, and no strain.
Contour, contour.
The contour is the real deal.
The secret is Contour's exclusive auto-active muscle toning technology, the digital breakthrough that automatically targets all your abdominal muscles, including your upper abs, lower abs, obliques, and even that stubborn lower belly. Thermographic testing proves Contour activates your entire core. The Contour Core Sculpting System comes with a one-size-fits-all Contour Core Belt, electronic controller with custom digital settings, batteries, and a one-year warranty, plus an instructional guide and sensible eating plan. And it's all yours to try for 30 days for just $14.95. There's never been an easier, more effective way to get great-looking abs. So call and order right now.
Round 14 at Shea Stadium. Champion Carlos Ortiz doing a masterful job against the game and gallant challenger Ismael Laguna. Ortiz, the trunks with the white stripe down the side, the lighter trunks. Laguna, the darker trunks. Remember September 28th, that's when Nino Benvenuti defends the middleweight title against Emil Griffith here at Shea Stadium, promoted by Madison Square Garden Boxing. Laguna with a brief rally. Laguna apparently has been told by his corner that the only way he can win is by a knockout, and he's probably going to go out and try to get it. Scoring in New York on a rounds basis with a supplementary point system if the rounds come out even on the cards of the... In the 14th round that Ortiz knocked out Flash Alordi last year at Madison Square Garden. Half over. round 10 of a 15-round bout for the lightweight championship. Ortiz in charge at the moment. They say protect yourself at all times. Ortiz scoring heavily. Seconds left in the round. A big round for the champion. Ten seconds left in round 10.
As Ortiz spun around, there was Laguna's face sitting right out in front. He scored a couple of pretty good sharp punches. It was a good round for Ortiz. Laguna, we're looking at him now, 135 pounds for this fight, a little bit heavier than most had expected him, although there's not too much to pick and choose from when you get down to weights this fine. He's 5'9", and yet doesn't have too much more reach than Ortiz. He comes from Colón, Panama. He was born there, a family of some 14 children. And this has had a tendency in the past to make quite a few fighters. You know, when you have to scramble yourself amongst a whole pile of sisters and brothers, you learn the reflexes pretty good. Ismael Laguna.
Round 11 at Shea Stadium. Carlos Ortiz, the champion, fighting a smart fight. Ismael Laguna, the former champion and challenger. No knockdowns in the fight so far. Hitting sparingly, but he's making the most of his punches. No question about that. He forced Laguna to break off the action there for a moment. 2 minutes left in round 11. No one knows, of course, how the rest of the bout will go, but up until now, Ortiz has shown why he is such a great champion, why he has been such a great champion. He seems to have everything in there, including good corner men. Is told to lead with a right hand as they hope Laguna will run into it. Half a minute left in this round. Over anxious, or he might have had him. Oh. 10 seconds left in the round.
toss and turn all night. Your back aches and your neck is in a knot. Introducing the all-new Sobakawa Cloud Pillow. A pillow 300 years in the making, based on the traditional Asian buckwheat pillow. The Sobakawa Cloud is filled with over 10 million air beads, a virtual sea of clouds that support your head and neck while keeping you cool and comfortable. Ordinary pillows are shaped like bricks. The Sobakawa Cloud's unique crescent shape is designed to follow the contours of your neck and shoulders. As you move, the beads move with you, maintaining both comfort and support. Plus, you'll never have to keep fluffing and flipping like ordinary pillows. This is truly a stay cool pillow.
I feel refreshed. And I don't feel the back of my hair stuck to my head because of its coolness.
Your head weighs about 10 pounds. If you don't get support, you wake feeling worse than when you went to bed. We placed eggs on the bottom of these cylinders, filled this cylinder with feathers from an expensive pillow. This 10-pound weight crushes the feathers and smashes the eggs. In this tube, we have stuffing from a fiber pillow, and it offers little resistance. Then we tried memory foam, and the weight wins again. Now watch as the weight hits the air beads. They absorb the shock, and the eggs are safe. Ordinary pillows flatten and lose their shape. The Sobakawa Cloud Pillow will keep its shape sleep after sleep after sleep. Order your Sobakawa Cloud Pillow for just $19.99. Order today and we'll also include the Sobakawa Pillowcase, a $10 value, and it's yours free. It's designed to breathe and continually adjust to the shape of the pillow. But wait, call right now and we'll double your order. You'll receive a second Sobakawa pillow and pillowcase for just the shipping and handling. That's just $19.99 for two Sobakawa pillows plus two free pillowcases. But you have to call now.
To order your Sobakawa Cloud Pillow, call 1-800-409-3128. Call now and get a second pillow for free. Call 1-800-409-3128 and order today.
Thanks to the Watch ESPN app, I don't miss nothing.
The new Watch ESPN app, the ESPN Network's live on your phone and tablet.
Round 12 at Shea Stadium, lightweight championship, produced by Madison Square Garden Boxing, Harry Markson, director. Question is now, can Laguna make it? He has had quite a going over in the last couple of rounds from Carlos Ortiz. Ortiz has not been able to bring him down, however. Ortiz in the lighter trunks or the blue trunks. Laguna, the dark trunks or the red trunks, depending on whether you're watching in black and white or in color. Round 12 of a 15-round bout for the lightweight championship, now owned by Carlos Ortiz. Ortiz is completely dominating the fight now. Laguna just can't get set. The same boxing, he can't get off.
And so can you.
Hit it!
You can get started right away. Log on now and we'll send you your free internet starter pack that will guide you through the step-by-step process to setting up your own home-based business.
My first month, I made over $2,700 profit.
If I can do it, you can do it. Get your internet starter pack today.
You could be making money wherever you are, right now. What are you waiting for?
Log on now and get your free internet starter pack today.
Round 7 of this fast lightweight championship bout, produced by Madison Square Garden Boxing at Shea Stadium. Carlos Ortiz, the lightweight champion, wearing the blue trunks. Laguna, the red trunks. Ortiz got mad that time and scored heavily with that left hook a couple of times. Ortiz, crafty champion, trying to lure his opponent into an opening for him. No question, Ortiz has scored the heavier punches tonight. See that 1-2 by Ortiz, the left and then the right, and the corner is right back at him. Laguna keeps working the body of the older man. Older, he's 30 years old. Older by 6 years. One minute left in round seven. Hardly been a dull moment. Laguna seems to be getting his second win. Ortiz scoring heavily and making Laguna hold. This is a great round of boxing. Ortiz looks at his corner again. Ten seconds left in round seven.
This lightweight championship fight is the first one outdoors in some 19 years in New York. And once the dam broke, they're going to do it again. There's going to be a middleweight championship fight coming up on the 28th, right here at Shea Stadium again. That'll be the first one since Basilio beat Sugar Ray Robinson back in 57. Nino Benvenuti and Emil Grizzly. And that one, too, should be a beauty. This is September 28th. Here, Carlos Ortiz corner again, and they are working on the eye, but again, don't seem overly concerned right now. Just about ready, as Ismael Laguna shows signs of stepping up the pace for the first time in the fight.
Round eight at Shea Stadium. Carlos Ortiz, the lightweight champion in the blue or the lighter trunks. Ismael Laguna in the red or the darker trunks. There have been no knockdowns. Laguna was rocked in round four and five. Did not go down. Laguna is now keeping the pressure on the champion, although Carlos is more than holding his own. Laguna's best punch of the fight. Ortiz scored heavily that time. Arthur McCanty trying to get them apart. Ortiz was cut around the right eye as early as the fourth round, but it hasn't bothered him. But I do see another trickle of blood over there. Laguna apparently unmarked. A minute to go in round eight. Now Laguna seems to be showing more respect for Ortiz.
Washboard abs. You know you want them. But crunches provide only limited short muscle contractions and create stress on your neck, shoulders, and lower back. Time to drop the excuses and get the T-Core for Men, the ab workout that revolutionizes the crunch, taking it off the floor and turbocharging it with a long-range motion against progressive resistance that targets your abs with every rep. In fact, T-Core delivers a gut-busting workout in three power moves that will target your entire core, upper abs, lower abs, and obliques. 1. Plug in the T-Core and feel your upper abs absolutely ignite as they compress the resistance cylinder. Resistance that generates a long, intense muscle contraction, a contraction that creates rock-hard chisel-cut abs fast. 2. Move T-Core to the side to instantly fire your oblique muscles and sculpt your waist. 3. Lean back for a leg raise that will completely zero in on your lower abs. 3 exercises, 6 minutes that will push you to the limit. T-Core will keep challenging you with 3 settings of 40, 80, even 120 pounds of ab-crunching resistance. It's like doing a lat pull against a 100-pound weight stack without the expensive equipment. T-Core can be yours for one payment. That's right, just one payment of only $29.95. T-Core comes with a 6-minute DVD workout and this gut check guarantee. Do the workout once. If you don't feel the burn in your upper abs, lower abs, and obliques without the strain on your neck and back, return it for a full refund of the purchase price. If you're serious about getting chiseled speed bump abs, T-Core for Men is the elite abdominal exercise you've been looking for. 3 exercises, 6 minutes, and only $29.95? Now there's no excuse. It's gut check time. Call now or go online to www.tc4men.com and order now.
Round 10 here at Shea Stadium, presented by Madison Square Garden Boxing. Lightweight championship of the world, the champion, Carlos Ortiz, scoring with that solid right hand. Still looking at his corner for instructions. Arthur McCanny gets them apart. Ortiz, the blue or the lighter trunks. Laguna, the red or the dark trunks. No knockdowns in the fight. A bit more holding in this round than usual.
Hi, Joe Fowler in a junkyard, and this is Restores It from Simonize, the amazing once-a-year car treatment that restores, polishes, and protects the finish on any car, any color, in any condition, for one full year. Even a junkyard dog like this. Just spray and wipe it away. Like magic, Restores It cuts through years of wear and tear, restoring the shine you thought was gone forever. Restores It is a once-a-year, 3-in-1 car finish treatment. It's a paint revitalizer that brings old paint back to life right before your very eyes. It's a professional detailer's polish that puts Simonized shine on any car, any color, in any condition. And it's a premium wax that seals and protects the Simonized shine for one full year. After 12 months and 100 washes, the water still beads up and runs away. If your car's finish is prime before its time, Restores It will turn back the hands of time. Ugly oxidation? Repair the devastation, swirl marks, and scratches with Restores It. Want to keep that classic looking classic? Restores It. And if you're tired of constantly waxing, get Restores It. Just spray and wipe it away once a year. And now Restores It with a professional microfiber finishing cloth is yours for just $9.95. It's from Simonize, the most trusted automotive brand in America for the last 100 years. Order now. We'll double the offer and send a second Restores It and microfiber cloth free. Just pay separate processing and handling. That's two for the price of one. And Restores It comes with an unconditional one-year money-back guarantee. If your car loses its showroom shine anytime in the next year, return the empty bottles and we'll refund your money. Restore, polish, and protect for a full year and a one-year money-back guarantee. Get Restores It from Simonize for only $9.95. Here's how to order.
This TV offer is not yet available in stores, so call now at 1-800-871-6984. That's 1-800-871-6984 or go to buyrestoresit.com.
Sunday Night Baseball. Every week, the best in the game are on baseball's biggest stage. Sunday night at 8 on ESPN, ESPN3.com, and ESPN Radio.
Round 5 at Shea Stadium. The champion, Carlos Ortiz, looking confident in the blue trunks. If you're watching in color, Ismael Laguna, the challenger, in the red. In black and white, Ortiz has the lighter trunks, Laguna the dark ones. Laguna, a fine champion himself, next champion now, is not flinching from Ortiz despite being rocked in the last round. Ortiz definitely trying for an early knockout. Laguna has been going for the body a lot more than we expected him to. So often, Ortiz looks over at his corner. The last time he looked, he was tagged by Laguna. He hurt him again. Ortiz hurt him again with that right hand. He's got him in real trouble. And half the round yet to go. Laguna trying to hold on for a moment. Got his left arm wrapped around Ortiz. In his corner, they yell at Ortiz, wait till he comes in. Don't lead, they yell at him. Ortiz has a slight cut above the right eye. Ortiz, a slight cut by the right eye, just above the right side of it. 1 minute to go in round 5. There have been no knockdowns yet. Laguna was rocked in round 4 and in this one. Now Ortiz has got to worry about that eye. He's got good corner men, Chicky Ferreira, Teddy Bentham, and manager Bill Daly. Nevertheless, it could be troublesome. Laguna holding Ortiz against the ropes. 25 seconds left in the round.
Corner man is Don Zolder, you're working on it now, and he's got good corner men. It became a little bit obvious during the round in watching Laguna that something that Don had pointed out to you earlier might be the most important part of the fight. Laguna was content to bide his time, and perhaps he too is counting on this very, very hot night and the fact that Ortiz is 30 years old. It might very well work to his advantage as the fight goes on longer and longer. Ortiz seemed to be trying to take his man out that time. He had his feet planted several times. He was looking for that one good hard shot. Ortiz is still moving well. We don't mean to indicate here he's showing any signs of tiredness at all. As a matter of fact, both men are moving just as freshly as they did when round one began. But it could be something to watch as this hot night and fight combine at Shea Stadium in New York.
Round six at Shea Stadium. Champion Carlos Ortiz on the right, Laguna on the left. Laguna sneaking in some pretty good punches himself, as you see. Champion Ortiz looks supremely confident. Laguna looks about the same as when he started. Ortiz again trying to set him up for that devastating right hand. Laguna very often will lead with his own right as he did then, and sometimes he gets away with it, but that was a half-hearted maneuver. 2 minutes left in the round. A hard left hook that time by the champion. Every so often, Ortiz looks out. He seems to be counting the house. There's a good crowd here, Carlos. More to worry about by Ortiz is that right eye. It's starting to bleed again just above it. And Laguna knows it. And so does Ortiz. This is round six. Bobbing head of Laguna's is hard to hit with a jab. One minute left in the round. A good 1-2 by the champion. Streak of blood down the face of Ortiz. Laguna speeding it up again. Ortiz with those good left hooks, and so is Laguna. Ten seconds left in round six.
I don't want to get up. I don't want to go to work. I hate mornings. Great, I have 20 minutes. No time for coffee. Hello, my friend.
Can't get it together in the morning? Try 5-Hour Energy. It's simple, effective, and unlike coffee, it's ready right now. No waiting, no hassle.
Let's do this.
5-Hour Energy, the no-wait, no-hassle way to a great morning.
This is getting good, real good. Who will move on in the NBA's ultimate drama? I can tell you from firsthand experience, this is special. Bulls. Hawks, Game 6, Thursday at 8 on ESPN.
The new Watch ESPN app. The ESPN network's live on your phone and tablet.
This is a public announcement. CNNMoney.com reports that in some areas of the country, buyers are scooping up homes for as little as $1,000. Foreclosures are at an all-time high. Government and private banks are liquidating these homes now. If you currently rent a house or apartment, you may call now and learn how to receive your free list of these homes. All others may call tomorrow. Every house must be sold. This is a public announcement.
Call 1-800-796-7086. That's 1-800-796-7086. Call now.
This is where I run my home business.